you're watching this video, it's probably Wednesday. I'm guessing it might not be Wednesday. It may be Wednesday adjacent, but it's certainly not Trump Tuesday. Trump predicted that he would be arrested on Tuesday, but he was not arrested on Tuesday. Now, I did see some stuff come out that this was not necessarily a leak, as he stated. You know, he states right here that it was an illegal, based on a legal leak. Turns out that this was most likely from, you know, a discussion that he had with his lawyers as they were giving him estimations. So that's a little bit different than having, you know, the sworn testimony. But still, he stated he would be arrested on Tuesday. Turned out he wasn't arrested on Tuesday. However, reports are now coming out that he could be arrested as early as this week. It's not, you know, not promised, but he might be arrested as early as Wednesday. He's going to be charged on Wednesday, according to this exclusive report for the Daily Mail. Now, one thing to note is, and it was also pointed out by the one of the journalists who worked at The Guardian, but he found out that there's no possible way that Trump could have been indicted on Tuesday because the group that is supposed to, you know, the jury is supposed to give out the indictments just wasn't meeting on Tuesday. So it was impossible for them to, you know, give out that indictment. But they are meeting on Wednesday. So it is extremely likely that Trump gets at least indicted, if not arrested. And like the article says, there are plans for the Secret Service to facilitate his surrender. And he's going to appear in court next week in New York. So how in the world did we get here, right? We know that Donald Trump put out the Truth Social post, but this all started years ago. So in 2006, allegedly, Donald Trump had an affair with Stormy Daniels, right? Then in 2011, Stormy Daniels spoke to the magazine In Touch and talked about the whole situation in exchange for $15,000. Then, in 2016, the National Enquirer then did what is known as a catch and kill. So what they did was they purchased exclusive rights for the account of the affair. They never released the story. It's called like catch and kill. So apparently, Cohen, a lawyer for Donald Trump that he had at the time, was the individual who sort of orchestrated this. And he purchased the non-disclosure portion of the company's deal for $125,000. And then later on, it's kind of well known that, you know, that Trump gave Cohen that money. Now, here's the interesting thing is that, you know, the part that, you know, potentially breaks the law is, you know, Trump using campaign funds to do this. And that part, I think, is the only part in dispute. Now, to be fair, you know, with this entire situation, Trump initially lied, you know, about the situation, right? He initially said that he did not pay to have Stormy Daniels silenced. But then after Cohen came out and said that it was true, I believe, and then some more evidence came out, he then admitted, yes, I did pay to have the story silenced, which, you know, kind of got me upset because, you know, the left has tried to pin the tail on the donkey for a while. But I think that this was the, you know, the only case where they were able to catch him in a truly bald-faced lie to the point where even Donald Trump admitted that it wasn't true. Now, here is the thing. The only part of this story that's under dispute is whether or not Donald Trump used his own money or used campaign finances. Because if he used campaign finances, that violates some campaign laws out of New York, which is the jurisdiction under which he's being tried, apparently, to be fair. And that part is in dispute, right? Trump says that he paid it out of his own pocket, but, you know, not everyone believes him. So it's a very interesting situation. Donald Trump is very upset, as shown by the fact that he's typing in all caps here, which I checked the Truth Social account. He does not always do. So someone interesting. Now, we did get this post from Donald Trump. In case you missed this, Donald Trump pointed out that one of his associates was going to be speaking with the individuals who was doing a lot of the, you know, investigating in determining whether or not, you know, there's enough evidence to move forward with indicting Donald Trump. And we got news of this. Big story out of Fox News. Bob Costello testified and said that Michael Cohen is a serial liar. This story came out. He essentially said that Cohen was lying. He's a serial liar. He's generally known for lying. And that's what Trump's tweet insinuates. Now, when this came out and Donald Trump did not get arrested, at first I thought it was literally just because, his testimony was so stirring. I mean, kind of an obvious defiance of what they were saying, because they were using Cohen as a source for a lot of this information. Cohen was like, yo, he paid me off, bro. He broke the law. And Bob Costello was saying, well, the dude's a liar. Well, apparently it's not enough, because apparently Donald Trump is going to get indicted, if not arrested, on Wednesday. Now, I'm extremely thankful for the fact that by all accounts, he's going to surrender. But I do hope that his supporters stay peaceful. And I hope that there's no interference of these protests by the FBI as they, infiltrating, the protests with groups like the Proud Boys. Similar things happened on January 6th. I'm just hoping that we're not getting a January 6th situation, which, to be honest, if we do get a repeat of January 6th where we have peaceful protests infiltrated by FBI individuals and then things just become violent from, feds and non-feds, this could be worse, because a lot of these protests are happening in New York in the street, because there were a lot of protests going on today. And there are tons of Trump supporters all across the country. And so if things are sparked off and become violent, more people could get hurt. People could actually, more people could get killed, businesses could be burned. Now, hopefully it's not what happens, right? And I'm hoping that, these protests don't get infiltrated, but you never know what's going to happen. So definitely everyone who is going to be out in the streets, please stay safe. Now, the BBC here kind of put out this article showing how excited they are about this. Fingerprints and a mugshot. What happens if Trump is arrested? They're very excited. They kind of put together this whole thing, which I personally don't find too interesting. But if you guys want to dig into it, the link is on screen. You can check it out. But in any case, this is very, very interesting. I'm kind of excited to see what will happen. I hope that Donald Trump does not get unjustly convicted of anything. Now, we do it just have faith in the justice system and let everything work its way out. The fact that they're going after Donald Trump seems highly political, especially right now, because we're in the heat of the 2024 race. We've got people coming up out of the woodwork announcing that they're running for president. Joe Exotic being one of them. But, the thing is, having a big reaction, I think, is kind of what the left wants us to do. Trump does say go out and protest, right? But Trump didn't say to go out and be violent, right? It's important to take into account. And we don't know for sure that Trump didn't commit a crime. We don't know whether or not Trump used his own finances or if he used campaign finances. And again, I don't know, the letters of the law, so I don't know whether or not that breaks the law. But if Trump broke the law, he should go to jail. It doesn't matter whether or not the actual prosecution of the law is political or politicized. He should still go to jail if he broke the law. Again, we don't know that. So I'm kind of looking forward to the investigation. I hope that the investigation is done in a transparent way so that people will be able to look at the evidence and very clearly agree with the result and be like, yeah, it makes sense that he, didn't get convicted and that he was acquitted. Or, oh yeah, it makes sense that he got convicted because we see this evidence here. So in any case, I hope that things are done in an above board way so that everyone can look at the situation and agree and be like, you know what? You're right. Trump is guilty or Trump is innocent. And this is not another one of those polarizing issues. We have too many polarizing events happening across the country. We really need, some unity in the country. And this just seems like something else that's going to cause even more division. But we'll see how things end up. We just got to sit tight, see what happens. In any case, it should be very interesting to watch. Right. And hey, for people who are worried about 2024, Trump running for president, first of all, if Trump gets arrested, it's going to literally seal the deal for him. He's going to be elected president as long as he continues to run. And second of all, we have plenty of other candidates, right? In case for whatever reason, Donald Trump can't run. Let's say that he's Jeffrey Epstein or something, right? we have so many better candidates who can run. I am not a fan of Ron DeSantis, but Ron DeSantis does seem to have, you know, a lot more, you know, grassroots GOP support than Donald Trump, especially among people who are extremely politically minded. There are a lot of other people who are considering running for president. Glenn Youngkin seems to be a reasonable individual. Nikki Haley seems okay, although I think the skeletons in her closet will probably come back to haunt her. But, you know, we'll see. The GOP Republicans should not be worried at all. Donald Trump is not going to be your savior, and there are plenty of other people who will be able to, you know, have good presidencies. You know, there's no need to be worried. So anyways, that's all I got. I would like to hear what you guys have to say in the comments. Kind of an interesting situation there.